Hi there, welcome to the all new episode of Phonedar Talk. I'm Amit and here's Karthik. And today we're going to talk about some interesting news of the day. Starting off with Apple iPhone 6. In the last 2 weeks, we have seen that Xiaomi has been in the news for their Xiaomi's Mi 4 and the Mi 5 smartphone getting blasted or exploding. And that's something which was something unexpected from a well-known brand. Now, the biggest news is that an Apple iPhone 6 has blasted. Again, it's exploded after a biker who was cycling, and when he fell down, the phone actually blushed and his leg has actually got third degree burn, which is something which we had not seen generally. And now this clearly brings in a point that we need to make a note that in case if you're doing some kind of physical activities, you shouldn't be holding your phone or you shouldn't be keeping it in your pocket, because you may end up in these kind of situations. The photos which you see right now on the screen can clearly show you how terrible this incident is, and I hope that Apple accepts its mistake, or Apple takes a note of this and ensures that something like this doesn't happen again. Moving on to the next news is from LG.
So LG has patented a new display technology. They call it the Ultra Wide Mobile Plus. So basically what's special about this technology is the aspect ratio of this device is expected to be 21:9. So usually these kind of aspect ratio are found basically in the cinema theaters and all those kind of displays. We haven't really seen such displays in smartphones at least.
But LG have recently launched a display with the same kind of resolution.
Yeah.
So probably we would be seeing smartphones which would be of this kind of form factor. But LG has been experimenting different things, like 3 years back they had launched the LG Woo series, then they launched the LG Woo 2. Again, they were a failed series, but they did try with a different kind of aspect ratio itself.
4:3, I guess. So very unusual shape.
And now they're coming up with 21:9. So that's a patent which they have yet right now blocked. So we should be seeing something probably in the next year from LG. Moving on to the next news is from Cheetah Mobiles. If you have never heard about this, it's the same company which has the Clean Mush and different kind of applications from the same. And the Clean Mush is one of those applications which is on millions of smartphones these days. And that brand has just acquired a new application called as News Republic. If you have ever heard about an application like News Hunt or Daily Hunt or even News Point or News Dog, these all are different news aggregator web applications which get their news from different websites like even our Phonedar, and they showcase you onto their application. Depending on your customizations, you can select the categories and get the latest news. So Cheetah Mobiles has just acquired the News Republic application at a price of around $57 million. Now that's the latest news from Cheetah Mobiles. Moving on to the next news is the biggest news of the day. That's Samsung is launching the biggest blockbuster of this year after the Mobile World Congress launch, which is the Galaxy S series. They're launching the Note 7 smartphone today.
Yeah, so basically Note 7 smartphone is officially launching today. The launch event is going to take place, that is the Unpacked event is going to happen in New York. And simultaneously in two other places like Rio and London as well. So it's going to happen, according to the Indian Standard Time, it's scheduled for 8:30 PM in the night. You can check in the links in the description for all the other timings for your local according to wherever you live. So
it's happening in different time zones obviously, and the event is at the same time, but according to your time zone, you can check out the time.
Yeah.
And it's happening today, so stay tuned for what's coming up. But let's move on to the same news around Note 7 in India, because most of you are from India. So let's talk about Note 7 news from India, and it's launching in India on 11th August. We got a copy of the invite of this event from Samsung, and it clearly mentions the 11th August. And we also heard that the phone won't be available right away to everyone, and probably it's possible that the phone will be in the market to everyone from August 19th. So probably the phone would be on pre-order once it's launched internationally and also in India, and then probably it should be coming in the third week or somewhere around the fourth week in this month. So that's about the news from Samsung for the Galaxy Note 7 series. Moving on to the last news, Life has launched a new smartphone.
Yeah, so we have another smartphone launch from Life. So this one is called the Wind 2. This is again one of the addition to their previously that the series that they had as the Wind series. So basically this is an affordable range of smartphones that they have. This is supposed to be priced at about, this is actually priced at about 8,200 rupees, which is actually more than what they already offered. Like all the previous Wind smartphones are priced at lower price. This is the most expensive in the Wind series. And talking about specifications, we are looking at about a quad-core 6735M MediaTek processor, 2GB of RAM and all those stuff. So you can check the description for all the details.
And there's also a 6-inch display. So this is probably more about media and entertainment kind of device rather than being a smartphone. And the best part is that these days with any of your life smartphone, you get a you get a Jio SIM card bundled with it.
All the free offer and everything.
Yes, and you also get the 3 months of free data and voice calling features. So if you are someone who is looking for those facilities, then go and check out the Life Mobile's offering and you can know more about the same. So the question of the day is that will you be purchasing the Samsung Galaxy Note 7 or would you be waiting for the Galaxy S8 which goes out next year? Let us know in the comment section, and I'm Amit and here's Karthik, and we hope to see you guys in the next video. Thank you.